नमस्ते स्टूडेंट्स, माय नेम इज जीवेंस डॉक्टर नीरज धोलिया, फैकल्टी ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर एंड वेटरनरी साइंस, ज्योति विद्यापीठ, वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी, जयपुर। तो इन दिस प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी वर स्टडिंग अबाउट द फ्यू बिहेवियर्स लाइक द कोऑपरेटिव बिहेवियर, द सेल्फिश स्पाइट एंड रेसिप्रोकल अल्ट्रिज्म बिहेवियर। तो इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल कीप कंटिन्यू टू स्टडी दैट बिहेवियर्स, and this lecture is related with the subject that is the behavioral science. So in the previous lecture we have studied that what is the cooperative behavior. It is the mutualistic relationship and the both the donor and the recipient are almost at the same level, because the both are benefited from each other and both are in the positive scenario. Positive means they are getting benefit from each other, and negative means they if they have in the loss or they have some harmful effects, that is represented by the minus or negative sign. So in the cooperative or mutualistic relationship, both are in the positive scenario, means they are in the same boat for their requirements. So the next was the altruistic relationship, and that is the donor at the cost of himself provides the benefit to the recipient, and in the general case the recipient will have the keen relationship to the donor, and the donation is one way. So behavior behavior where benefits are donated alternatively in both direction at the cost of often called the altruistic, but on analysis such altruism can be seen to arise from optimized selfish strategy. So reciprocal altruism was also there, that is the term were used by evolutionary biologists and psychologists to characterize a decision to help with an exception that one will receive some benefit or the paying off doing so. Then we studied the spite, and spite is essentially a reverse form of the altruism, where an individual is damaging the competitors, and in the general case is the individual is in the kin relation related, and the benefit is an easier competitive environment. Spite, we have discussed various examples of the spite, how the insect infanticidal effects in the lions, and other examples we have studied. Then the next is the selfishness, and the selfishness was remained to explain. So today we will discuss about the selfishness. So selfishness is the base criteria for all strategic choice from a game theory perspective. Strategies not aimed at self-survival and self-replication are not long for any game. Critically, however, this situation is impacted by the fact that competition is taking place on multiple levels, at the genetic level, at the individual level, and the group level. So selfishness can be, again, it can be at the genetic level, it can be at individual level, or it can be at group level. So as we have studied that the selfish gene, about the selfish gene by the Richard, scientist Richard, and they told that the genes are selfish, means they need to replicate themselves by any means. Okay, so the selfish behavior occurs when one individual benefits at the expense of another. So in this case, the other one is got harmed, and the self one is benefited. So examples are the examples of the selfishness can be seen in the various animals, and the examples surprisingly are common in birds. But in birds, the female sometimes exhibit egg dumping behavior. So egg dumping behavior or the intraspecific brood parasitism. parasitism. So what is the intraspecific brood parasitism? So that is the laying of eggs in the nest of other spheres. Thus, the parasiting their parental care means they are hijacking the parental care of the other pair. Okay, even though female birds usually cannot tell their eggs from those of other cone species females. This sort of parasitism is not particularly common, probably because territoriality and nest guarding help to minimize it. Because it may be possible that in the territory of the egg laying bird, it is not having the empty of food. So it will put its eggs in the other's territory that have the sufficient amount of food and the care. So cone species brood parasitism, however, occurs in over 30 species of ducks and geese, as well as in the northern bob-white quill. That is, it is also found in the ring-necked peasant and wood pigeon, and the European starling, cuckoo, and a variety of other species. So heterospecific brood parasitism is even more common with cuckoos and the cowbirds. So the eggs can be laid on the other pairs, the nest of the other pairs of the same species. But in the other species, it can be possible that the birds lay their eggs in the birds of the other species. So it is common in the cuckoos and the cowbirds, which lays eggs in the nest of the diversity of other species. So again, it is about the selfishness or self behavior, and spite as a social interaction present an interesting puzzle, it is a behavior that causes harm to the actor and recipient. And spite is thought to evolve in situations where it serves as a signal of status that helps the actor in the future. In the absence of such future benefits, it should be not evolved. Okay, so that was about the behaviors, different behaviors we have studied, and we have studied the cooperative behavior, where both the animals, both the individuals are get benefited from each other. We have studied the altruism, where the recipient is in positive side and the actor is in the negative side, means get harmed. We have studied about the selfish. In the selfish, the actor is in the is benefited and the recipient is harmed. Spite, we have also studied about the spite in the previous lecture, and that is the negative behavior, means the actor and the recipient both are in the negative side, means both are in the none of them get benefited, both are in the minus condition. So that was all about the cooperation, reciprocal, selfish, and the behavior. So this was all about the subject in the topic, and in the next lecture we will study about the aggressive behavior patterns in the animals. So we have already discussed about the introduction of the aggressive behavior, which is shown in the territorial behavior. It is related with the territorial behavior and the food sharing behavior, and the aggressive behavior can be shown in intraspecific or in the interspecific. Okay, so aggressiveness, if it is in the intraspecific, it can be shown when the food sharing for the common sources, for the food, for the habitat, for the reproduction. And if it is the interspecific, so then it can be for the habitat and the territory. And if the food is common, then it can be possible for the food also. So aggressive behavior is shown by variety of animals, variety of birds. Almost all animals and birds have the aggressive behavior on the specific sign, danger, stimuli. Okay, so that will be studied in the next lecture. So hope you are satisfied with this digital session. If you have any query or any doubt, you can write in the comment box. I will resolve that. I will solve your query. And this session is powered by Digital Version 2, Jyoti Vidyapeeth Women's University, Jaipur. Thank you.